Okay, so next, let's look at the fourth step of the ECG interpretation is how to decipher the axis of the ECG. Okay, so as you can see, the normal axis, okay, if you can look at the normal axis, all right, the normal axis follows the direction of the conduction from the SA node to the AV node, and it goes down to the bundle of His and to the Purkinje fibers. So as you can see, this is the angle for the normal axis. Unfortunately, sometimes the axis may deviate, right, to the left or to the right. What happens is that sometimes there is left ventricular hypertrophy and the muscle thickens. And once it becomes thickens, it starts taking more electricity than normal. Once the left side starts taking more electricity than normal, the axis will shift towards the left. As in sometimes the right ventricle or the atrium becomes hypertrophied, and now the right side starts taking more electricity, and that may cause the axis to deviate to the right side. Okay, so how do we see the axis from the ECG? Okay, so how do we calculate the normal, how do we calculate the axis? Very simple. All right, I know you've seen many formulas everywhere. Sometimes axis calculation will be very confusing. I'll give you the simplest method ever to calculate the axis. Just look at two leads, leads 1 and leads 3. Okay, lead 1 and lead 3. Just look at these two leads and imagine lead 1 being the boyfriend and lead 3 is being the girlfriend, and seeing how they interact with each other tells you the direction of their relationship. Okay, so in this ECG, look at lead 1, it is an upward deflection. Lead 3 is an upward deflection. Both of them are in the upward deflection, so both of them are moving in the same direction. Okay, if the girlfriend and the boyfriend is moving in the same direction, means they have a normal relationship, alright? A normal relationship, and it is there is no abnormalities yet in their relationships, okay? So if leads 1 and leads 3 is in the same direction, mean it's a normal relationship, normal axis. Now, look at the boyfriend and look at the girlfriend, alright, for this ECG. Lead 1 is deflected upwards. Lead 3 is deflected downwards. So if you can see, both of them are moving the opposite direction, okay? So lead 1 and lead 3, the boyfriend and girlfriend, they are leaving each other, alright? So they are leaving each other, alright? So the relationship is not working out. So this is known as a left axis deviation. They left each other. So it is a left axis deviation when lead 1 and lead 3 is in opposite directions of each other. Okay, so now let's look at this ECG. If you can see lead 1 is deflected downwards, and lead 3 is deflected upwards. So lead 1 and lead 3 are meeting each other, which means they are right for each other. This relationship, the boyfriend and girlfriend, they are meeting each other, all right, and they are right for each other. So this is where we call that this is a right axis deviation. Okay, so to recap, if the 1 and 3 is moving in the same direction, means they are normal. It's a normal axis. If leads 1 and leads 3 are moving away from each other, all right, then it is a left axis deviation. If leads 1 and lead 3 meet with each other, then it is a right axis deviation. So use the story of this boyfriend and this girlfriend and the direction of the relationship to determine the axis, whether it's normal, right, or left axis deviation.